you're not Callie.
No.
Well, you must be her mother?
In-law.
Right. Very next thing I was gonna say. I came to see Jeff. Is he here?
He's doing his homework.
Well, he had a pretty rough morning. Thought I'd come by.
Yeah, I know. Well, he's fine.
Okay. Is Callie here?
No.
She work?
Uh-uh.
School?
Nope.
When will she be back?
None of your damn business. Overdue orange. Repo red. Poor house purple. Oh, my God, girl, don't you wish there were a pot of gold at the end of this rainbow.
Are you trying to cheer me up?
Callie, you're not the first person to get a little behind on your bills.
I'm more than a little behind.
Well, have you talked to Ray about this? Because, I don't know, maybe he could do something.
How?
I don't know, but you
hey,
have to ask...
honey, did you eat yet?
I'm not hungry.
In about 4 days, someone's having a birthday, I think. Pretty big one, too.
Yeah, whatever.
Ray promised to take him shooting when he turned 13.
Well, hell, I can do that. Used to take your daddy all the time.
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Grandma.
Hey, listen, buddy, I'm a good shot. This could be fun. Sorry to interrupt, but your daddy's on the phone. And he'd like to wish you happy birthday.
All right, great.
But why don't you take it in the other room? And that way y'all have more privacy.
Okay, you set the game up. I'm player number one.
Oh, hey, Jeff. You know what? Next time. And I just came by to say happy birthday. You know, the...
Okay, well, thank you.
All right, happy birthday.
Thanks.
No, yeah, birthday boy is right here.
What about branding?
I haven't branded yet.
No branding? Denny.
Denny.
Oh, Denise Bauer. Candy Springtime, public relations.
Hello.
Hi.
She's with Sherling Thompson, the same public relations firm the government uses, so you know she's good.
Denise, we're rolling out a new campaign to take back the story on Mr. Blaney.
Take back the story?
Yeah, oh, Denny tells me that you haven't branded him yet, so I took the initiative and created a brand. Russell Blaney, American homeowner.
American homeowner.
Simple. It's to the point.
Cozy.
Say it for me, Denny. Press conference voice.
Russell Blaney, American homeowner. Wait a minute. American homeowner, Russell Blaney. See, it works both ways. Versatile.
But do we really think that we need to label Mr. Blaney?
Denny?
Denise. Rodney King.
Rodney King, severely beaten by the police over 10 years ago.
See, you remember. Why? Branding. That's what we want. Russell Blaney, American homeowner.
Okay, now this is just a mock-up. Obviously, we will replace Jimmy Stewart with Mr. Blaney, but the banner can and should be behind you every press conference, Denny. Notice I used the same font as Mission Accomplished. Americans are comfortable with that font. Now, we will send B-roll of Mr. Blaney to the press, working in his garage, using his table saw, working with his power tools, fixing things around the house. And as far as the talking points, keep it simple, Denny. Speak of the opposition as the drug-crazed intruder. The incident as the harrowing home invasion. Now, I know you're tight with Larry King, but we are negotiating with Nightline, Hardball, and The Daily Show. That is where most Americans get their news. Hurry up, ladies. Cosmos are waiting.
Nadia, they're looking for Lang.
Oh. Jealous husband?
FBI.
Oh, well, can this wait? We'll be back by 10.
Yeah, how about we come with you?
Only if he comes too.
That was the plan.
Done!
Last time Liam was seen alive was on one of your cruises about a month ago.
Hey, I don't keep track of the boys who go on my cruises. My God, that'd be a full-time job.
As opposed to arranging hookups.
For a cub, he certainly knows how to take the romance out of things.
We're not talking about him. We're talking about you. So middle-aged women pay you to hook up with younger guys?
No, they don't. They pay to go on my cruises. What they do when they get off is up to them.
Right. Well, one of your guests ended up fish food at the bottom of the sea. I'm not seeing the romance in that.
And he usually does, which means there really isn't any.
Hey, I liked Liam. He was very good for business.
Yeah, you took advantage of a kid who didn't have a mother. You basically fed him older women.
He needed mature companionship, and my ladies needed a fresh face.
And youthful physique.
Exactly.
You know, there are plenty of guys in their 30s and 40s who have youthful physiques.
Yeah. It's different. Not in a bad way, but...
Yeah, in a bad way.
You're not helping your case.
If something happened to Liam that night, I have no idea what it is.
Guy was stuffed in a fish locker, in a cabin that you seem to spend a lot of your quality time in.
Okay, how could I put him in a locker I don't even have a key to?
Who has the key?
Well, Captain Kelly. Maybe it's him you should be talking to.
Oh, you're a little early.
I think we're right on time.
No, actually, we're starting the ceremony at 7.
Starts at 7.
Actually, I hope we don't start the ceremony at all.
Oh, is there a problem?
Yes, there's a problem.
You don't like the mortuary?
Not keen on the mortuary, but it's something bigger than that.
Liam is gay.
Yes, Liam is gay, but that is not the problem.
My daughter's too young.
No, of course not.
Then what's the problem?
Your daughter's a prostitute.
That's the problem? Well, I'm sorry to hear that, honey, because I'm also a prostitute.
Yes, the invite from the St. Petersburg House
of Discreet Pleasure. Yeah. Well, yes. Could you sing funded this event? You
know I've seen a website.
It's great, right? The flesh is new. Yeah. It's this guy from Bangalore. Oh, we outsource. Wonderful. What are you going to do? Cheaper rates, you know?
How discreet can a house of pleasure be if it can be found on the internet?
Well, it's secret. It's password protected.
Oh, is it? Yeah. Well, we got in right away.
Well, good. I'm glad to hear.
You paid the fee. I'm a member.
Yeah, he's a member.
For research.
We're all trying to make Marina and Liam happier. We have good, you know, my friend Terrell, he's my realtor. He's going to be the priest.
I'm stopping this farce.
Okay, you're not stopping any farce. The wedding is going on tonight at 7 p.m.
The wedding is not going on tonight at 7 p.m. No. Or any other night at 7 p.m.
Really?
That's right.
I challenge you.
You do.
To a duel.
Splendid idea.
4 p.m.
4 p.m. where?
The fencing place in Reseda.
I know where that is. The sword play.
Then you can give me a ride.
I can give you a ride?
No, he can give me a ride.
No, I'm not going to give you a ride. I have to do his wedding arrangements.
Miss Johnson. How would you describe your relationship with Mr. Pope?
He's my boss.
And isn't he also a sexual partner?
Excuse me?
For the record, this is exhibit number 3, a letter written by Miss Johnson to Mr. Pope, discovered by my client among her husband's belongings. Is this your handwriting, Miss Johnson?
That letter was written a long time ago, before Chief Pope ever met a step.
Was Mr. Pope married to someone else at the time?
This is my personal correspondence. No, it has nothing to do with this.
I object. This line of questioning is way beyond the subpoena and borders on harassment.
Oh, on the contrary, Miss Johnson's previous relationship with the respondent brings into question issues of character and integrity which she herself has raised. And frankly, I wonder how the thousands of officers who report to Assistant Chief Pope would feel about his honor and integrity if they knew he'd promoted his mistress to be his deputy. And when I saw him, I said to Dick, I knew it wouldn't be long before Bill Henriksen got into the bar business. I mean, an entrepreneur is an entrepreneur.
We're really not in the bar business.
Well, but gaming and bars
go together. They do. They go together, Barb.
We have to say that we really didn't expect you to be in the bar business, Meredith.
And why is that?
Well, you know why.
Preconceptions.
Preconceptions, right, Bill? You know, the idea that just because we don't drink liquor, we should stay out of the business of selling liquor. Well, you know what Dick says. Saints can run a racket better than any Gentile.
You've been talking to Sonia, huh? Right? What, is she a fatty now or what?
Make good on that threat, Doreen?
Because Benny was murdered that night.
Oh, yeah? Well, that's news to me.
Where were you when the fire started?
On the floor with my partner, Ken. What, did Sonia tell you I whacked Benny?
You denying you made a threat?
I might have said something. As a psych out.
To win the contest?
Yeah. $1,000? It's like $1 million to us back then. And Ken needed that money. Bad.
Why is that?
There's ancient history, right? I can't get in trouble for breaking any narcotics laws.
We're homicide.
Well, back then, coke was a drug of choice.
Sue, focus.
All right. Okay. Maybe I did overdo it with the happy homemaker thing, but I only did it because I wanted to be a better mom. Like you, you know, I see how you connect with your kids, you know, with the hugs and the muffins and that, and I just wanted a little of that for Vanny and me.
So I think it's great that you want to be a good mom, but can't you do it at your house?
Oh, I can't cook and clean at my house. I have people for that.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I think I'm gonna be... Hello, Peter. Lock that other door. Now!
Betsy?
Nobody comes in or I kill you both.
Such a fucking idiot.
Oh. Like, I should have dumped him years ago.
Oh, yeah.
I feel 20 pounds lighter.
More like 180 pounds.
Hold this, driver.
Hey, Swiaggies, okay? Because I feel like dancing. Oh, look what I found. I'm getting